The take.
Jewels of the Salton Sea.
Over the shoulder?
Over the shoulder. Take three.
Thank you. And take in Michael, please. And action, please.
How are you?
Good.
Thank you for having me. I think perhaps you're some sort of angel to come down and protect it.
Yes.
Or save it.
Go for it.
Jewels of the Salton Sea. Scene one, take three.
Okay, second. And whenever you're ready, Michael.
Michael!
Hello, great.
It's so great to see you.
How are you?
Oh, good.
Nice to be here.
Thank you, you're so tall. Well,
thanks to my father, I suppose.
Uh-huh.
Or my mother. But I guess I give them both the credit. It's almost like a different world, like another planet. What you would dream another planet might be like. You know? Fresh water.
You can hear the sounds of the wave of the sea.
Very gentle. Very, very gentle feeling. I just thought how wonderful it would be to actually be here, you know? And I know how you feel. I know how passionate you are about it.
I am at the Salton Sea on a journey, a fantastic journey, and for a great purpose. Here to gain research and to understand more about what surrounds me. What we capture on our film camera will tell you a story about the Salton Sea. And along with our findings, you too will realize that it is of a crown jewel, not just for the Salton Sea, but for our planet.
What a view. The jewels of the Salton Sea. Flying over the sea is breathtaking.
Hey, Chris. Oh, yeah, I've got you guys in sight.
After a long sightseeing flight, Grace, an experienced desert helicopter pilot, made contact with the film crew. Today, she meets up with director Stephen Vitali, who is there to film her arrival. However, during her quest to show the Salton Sea's beauty, she uncovers that California's largest lake is shrinking. The mud pots at the Salton Sea. Mysterious, turbulent, and bubbly hot. A geothermal phenomenon to many scientists. He assures Grace that he will be back.
Okay. Right back.
While the director and film crew await for his return by the boiling mud pots and in the heat of the sun, time is crucial. Today, Grace joins an expedition with Dos Palmas Bushman and expert guide, Joel Miner, who knows every inch of the preserve. This jungle-like setting is real, and so you do need to be careful. Depending on the time of the year and the temperature, you do need to be mindful of seeing a rattlesnake.
Jasmine, tell me, what does the Salton Sea mean to you?
To me, the Salton Sea means natural beauty and life. I've always been fascinated with the wildlife here.
I'm at the Salton Sea.
Meanwhile, on this day, the Salton Sea State Recreation Area is busy with Sea Fest, a fun community service. People coming from all over, reaching out and inspiring others. Great food, music, dance, something for everyone. California.
The Salton Sea, like La Quinta, is young, but with rich history. Frank Capra, director, The Lost Horizon. Congressman Sonny Bono, actor, singer, father, politician. These men had vision. I came to the desert years ago, never thinking I'd be mayor. There's opportunity, there's inspiration, there's experiences.
That is something I call a floating in-sea habitat, acronym FISH, and it is designed for exactly that purpose. It's a little refuge in which the tilapia, which are the dominant fish in the sea, would be able to breed. We're setting it up as a place that we could manage the salinity so we can create a little area of ocean salinity within the more salty Salton Sea, and which is optimum for the young fish to grow from eggs to little fish fry and grow up. And then when they become adults, they can survive in the high salinity of the Salton Sea.
Bombay Beach is a special place. And although this small town has had its share of challenges, it's a community of caring people. This abandoned boat is of striking artistic expression. Grace climbs aboard. Looks like she has found her sea legs.
We're in the middle of the Salton Sea at the north end. We're on our way to the Whitewater River Delta. The river deltas and the mouths of the agricultural drains are places where the birds congregate. They need that fresh water just like we do, even though they're comfortable foraging the salt water.
And that dry playa has particulate matter in it, dust in it, that's harmful to the birds, humans, crops, and is just dangerous from all those aspects, so that's why it's in part of the mitigation plan.
Along the west shores of the Salton Sea, we listen to the extraordinary people who are doing what it takes to help restore and save the sea. Meanwhile, birds with intrinsic value are waiting to be fed, not knowing when dinner will be served. For these birds, the importance of a water source is very clear. Located on Marina Drive in the Salton City is the Alamo Restaurant. Grace has been invited to taste a homemade recipe that attracts people from all over. Mexican cuisine with local ingredients.
A lot of customers, they like to try the salsa. This is a homemade salsa. That's the one we make by myself. We have the recipe, it's a homemade recipe.
Well, I'm not a scientist either. But you know what? I know a lot of really good scientists. at NASA and at NOAA and at our major universities, and the best scientists in the world are all telling us that our activities are changing the climate. And if we don't act forcefully, we'll continue to see rising oceans, longer, hotter heat waves, dangerous droughts and floods, and massive disruptions that can trigger greater migration and conflict and hunger around the globe. The Pentagon says that climate change poses immediate risks to our national security. We should act like it.
In my years here at the Salton Sea, I've seen so many animals and met so many people that are truly afraid for their health.
It was a very, very controversial decision when IID entered into it. It was a 3-2 vote, and it was passed on a very, very, very small margin.
There are people who are ready to step up today.
Sometimes you have to hit bottom before you realize you have to do something. And I think we've pretty much hit bottom on this, and people realize from the state, the federal government, not just the Coachella Valley, that we have to do something about this, or it's going to be an ecological disaster for Southern California.
Water is so important to our planet. We see it mismanaged everywhere. The rain patterns are not there. I'm a farmer. We see our farms drying up. From the 80s, it was always raining twice a year. We've been in a 3-year drought, that's in Australia. I see the droughts in California increasing and droughts across the United States, including the East. We see the imbalances, the pollution, the mismanagement of water. It's just really needs to be addressed. And it's such an urgent, critical issue. If we don't address it, what do we have?